about trade all the time, particularly U.S.-China trade, but how important is the trade for China? Is it more important for China or for India, and, or for the United States, rather? And how intertwined is the Chinese economy upon not only the U.S., but the rest of the world? Professor of Economics Emeritus at the University of Massachusetts Amherst, Richard Wolff, joins us now to discuss. Professor, welcome. And there's some really apropos news just out within the last hour. The Federal Reserve just released their meeting notes from their January Federal Open Markets Committee meeting. And in those, it highlighted the risk to the economy, the U.S. economy, of going forward, including the possibility of a sharper than expected downturn. And they note particularly China and EU as potential concerns. What's your reaction to that, Professor?
Well, I think it's now a sign of several months that the Federal Reserve, unlike so many politicians, is facing the reality that the American economy is not the envy of the world, that the American economy is in shaky position, and that the hope of the Federal Reserve to raise interest rates and to pull back the enormous increase in money that it dumped into the economy after the crash of 2008, it has to stop doing that. Our economy is too fragile. If they keep raising interest rates, people won't be able to afford a mortgage, won't be able to afford their car payments, and all the rest of the shaky card situation will collapse. And so what you're seeing is the Federal Reserve saying, in light of the troubles with China and trade, in light of the problems of Europe, the United States is just too fragile to allow us to do what we had hoped we could do, but the fragility is so serious, we have to hold back. It's a real wake-up call for people to understand how shaky the U.S. economy actually is.
And just as a note to our viewers, Professor Wolff sort of said that several times, actually, earlier this year and even late last year, that was probably what the Fed should be doing. So it remains to be seen whether or not they will raise rates. But certainly they're having that discussion inside that closed door meeting. And those are the notes we just received an hour ago. So, Professor, is a trade deal more important for China than it is for the U.S., or is it both? Are they both important?
They're both important. Both countries are affected by this. When Mr. Trump started this game of applying tariffs, of having the government directly intervene in manipulating markets, something conservatives used to say they were against, it set off lots of problems for China and lots of problems here in the United States. I believe both governments now are trying to undo, back away from, the very problems those tariffs started. But they have to save face in both countries. They have to come away looking as though they did well or as well as can be expected in order not to get troubles inside their respective countries. Here's the more important thing. China is an up-and-coming country. It knows it has to deal with the United States as the big player on the block. It has to go easy. It has to accommodate. But it believes, and the statistics support it, that the wind of progress is favoring them. And so they're willing to adjust to a point. If Mr. Trump crosses that point, we're going to have more trouble, and it'll be bad for both economies.
You know, one of the reasons that I wanted to ask you that last question about, which is it more important for, and 100%, I mean, makes sense. We're such a large economy in the U.S., they want our business. But, I mean, there are Chinese products all over the world. I mean, they really are doing a great job of manufacturing. I mean, I shouldn't say great for all the workers, but they're doing a great job of getting their products around the world. So how dependent is the Chinese economy, save the U.S., on the rest of the world, Professor?
Well, I think the reality is that the Chinese understood already years ago, long before Mr. Trump became president, that they were too dependent on the global market, too export-oriented. So they commenced the process of becoming much more domestically focused, realigning their industries to serve a domestic market. But that takes some years to do, and they're kind of in the middle of that process. But you're right. They are very efficient. They have broken into markets across the world. You can see it very starkly in the Huawei company, where that executive was arrested in Canada, and we're trying to get the companies hurt by not getting contracts with other governments. The Europeans won't go along. They want those products because the Chinese Huawei company is way ahead of its rivals, American and elsewhere. So, yes, it's an economy that is hurt by all of this, but they're not on the edge of disaster. They will get through this. They've planned for this. And I just hope that Mr. Trump doesn't misestimate this situation and push it over that dangerous line.
Well, in that regard, let me just finally ask you before we run out of time here, what do you expect is going to happen between now and March 1st when those tariffs would be increased, unless the president, I guess, President Trump seems to think that progress is being made?
Here's what it depends on. If Mr. Trump can get enough of a deal out of the Chinese so that he can parade as having achieved something, we will get a deal. This doesn't depend on the Chinese as much as it depends on the optics, as our political commentators say, the optics of Mr. Trump's role in pushing the world around to make America first. If the Chinese give him enough and he can play that properly, we'll get a deal. If he doesn't get enough and he keeps going, then we're going to get close to that line that pushes a trade war into something much more scary.
Yeah, I mean, it seems to me that we either get to the real issues of control, patents, et cetera, IP theft, because they'll easily go ahead and buy just some more goods, some soybeans, some beef, et cetera, to pacify us. If that's all it takes for a political victory in the U.S., I get you 100%. Professor Richard Wolff, professor of economics emeritus at University of Massachusetts Amherst, thank you so much. Always a delight, Professor.
Glad to talk to you, Bart. Look forward.